What's up, y'all? So it's been a little minute since I did a little car video, but I just want to come and encourage somebody, get out of your head. Get out of your head. Stop allowing the enemy to use those negative thoughts. Stop allowing the enemy to make you second guess what you're called to do. Stop allowing the enemy to do that. Get out of your own way. Get out of your own head. Sometimes it's not the enemy. Sometimes it's us getting in our own way. Sometimes it's us second guessing, like, did God really say that? I had a dream last night, and as I was waking up from the dream, you know, the dream wasn't that profound to where I got revelation, but it was when I was waking up from the dream. Actually, the last part of the dream, sorry, correction, the last part of the dream was where someone was talking to me about encouraging women. And I was like, yeah, if women just knew to get out of their own way, get out of their head, and to not take down their pictures on social media, because the enemy is using that to make them lose their engagement or something. And I woke up and I was like, wait a minute, that couldn't have been a work. But you know, God speaks in all different kinds of ways, and I do feel like social media is a place where a lot of women specifically feel insecure. They feel like they can't do anything. So like, you get in your own way, you get in your own head, and God has called some of you to create on social media, to create engagement, to create, you know, you're super creative. And so he's called you to that area, but you're in your own way, you're in your own head. And I'm just coming today to encourage you and to tell you just a short word: get out of your own head, get out of your own way. Post on social media. Don't worry about the likes. Don't worry about who sees it. You know, just be obedient and let your creativity flow and do it, and be consistent and just keep going and just get out of your own way. It's when you get out of your own way and you actually are intentional about seeing the will of God manifest in your life, that's when you will start seeing the will of God manifest in your life. It's not just, I'm going to sit back. We know that faith without works is dead, right? So it's not just, I'm just going to sit back and the will of God is just going to appear. The will of God, I heard this once before, and I used to be like, oh, I hated to hear it. But the will of God is not automatic. And, you know, sometimes we have to align our faith with what it is that we feel like God is calling us to do. And I'm here to tell you that God is saying, get out of your own way, get out of your head, post more, create more, allow the creativity that he put in you to shine. So Heavenly Father, I pray right now for the person on the other side of that screen, that you would allow them, Father God, that you would give them the ability, the grace, the strength to get out of their own head, to combat those negative thoughts that are only coming from insecurities, that are coming from the enemy, that are coming from past failures. But Father God, that you would allow your plan for their life to manifest, that you would give them the ability to operate in faith, that you would give them the wisdom to know what steps to take, what works to do, so that their faith can be aligned, so that they can see everything that you have in store. Yes, some things you're just going to drop in their lap, but some things they're going to have to get out of their own way on. And Father God, I pray that over them in Jesus' name. Amen. Y'all already know I love y'all so much, and I will see you next time.